This is a video to show the most straightforward way that I've found to change black and white films into colour ones. If people like me who are into old black and white films and TV shows and you wish to see them in colour, this is the best way to do it, I've found, having tried many different ways to achieve this. Before you look at correcting and colorizing any black and white footage, what you need to do is look at it and think, now does it need enhancing or improving in any way before I turn it to color? Now if it does, I found that the best program to use to do this is Topaz Enhance Video AI, and here it is here. And for the purposes of this demonstration, I have a clip from the very first episode of The Man from U.N.C.L.E., which I'm just going to use to show what I do. So I'm dragging that clip in here. And what you can do then is you have various settings to the right of this to be able to try and improve it in any way you think you can. And also you have a model here, like I use the Thayer fine tune detail model. There's quite a few of them to choose from, but I found that this one gives the very best results. And once you've done that, then what you do is you go to the bottom here and you select PNG 8-bit lossless, and it will convert every frame of this clip once you click start processing into another folder on the desktop here, and then you'll have the film ready to take to the next step. In actual fact, I'm not going to use this on this particular clip because it's already pretty good quality really. So what I'm going to do is this. I have a program by DVD VideoSoft, which is free video to JPEG converter. And then I'm going to drag this clip straight into this program, and I'm going to tell it to export every frame of it. Click convert, and it will very, very quickly convert every frame of this to a JPEG image, which is quite sufficient if the film's good quality, I find. And there we are, it's already done it. And we've actually got 1039 separate frames now, which we need to put through the colorizing process. So for the next step, what you need to do on your desktop is create a new folder, and I'm going to call that colored images, but you can call it anything you want. That's where Photoshop is going to store your images. So then we need a fairly new version of Photoshop, and we're going to open up the very first file of this sequence. There it is. Then we need to go to Window, Actions, and we need to create a droplet. So I'll call that droplet, and then we need to select this, which is going to record every action that we do. So I'm going to call this colored frames, and now I'm being recorded every action. So we then go to filter, neural filters, and when that loads up we can select colorize on this frame. There's colorize. Okay, that's going to color that, but as you can see it's a little bit on the red side, so we can take the red down. That seems to happen a lot with this process. It's very hard to get the colors just right. You can play with these sliders as best you think. So I normally move up the color artifact reduction as well, and then I click OK. Now what we need to do is to save this first image click save, go to the desktop and into the coloured images folder, open, save. Okay, now that's the very first frame completed, so we can now click stop on this recording. Then we need to go to File, Automate, Create Droplet. Okay, so we're going to save the droplet in the desktop, although you can save it where you like, but that's where I need it to be, in the desktop. Now these all look correct here. Now we're going to go to this side and it's going to ask for a destination folder, and the destination folder is desktop colored images. Select that. Okay, now we can minimize Photoshop, and there's the droplet, and there's the file that we want it to action and color every frame. So we're going to move that file onto the droplet. That's just saying that the first one's already done, so you click OK. And now Photoshop is going to automatically color every frame of this clip, and it's going to store it. So let's have a look in the storage folder now, which is colored images, and there you can see as it's colorizing this, it's just putting it all into that folder, and it will carry on doing that now until it's colored every single frame. Now when I first started doing this, I found that my computer was struggling to cope with it because it's quite an old computer. But if you're worried about this, you can actually open up Task Manager and you can see how your computer is coping. If you click on Performance, well, my CPU at the moment is on 44%, 35, 42, because it tends to use the CPU more than the GPU for this process. You'll see the GPU is on 17, 8. It uses it a little bit. But I found when I was first doing this that the CPU was running on 90 something percent and the computer was really struggling. So what I ended up doing was replacing my processor for a quad core processor. And now, as you can see, it's handling it fine on here. So there you go. You just come back later when all the files have been completed. Go and have a cup of tea. So I've been for a cup of tea or two and I've come back to the computer, and Photoshop has now done 1039 colored images and stored them in the colored images folder. So the next thing we need to do is be able to stitch these images back together and make a video. And also I'm going to add the soundtrack from the original black and white clip, and we'll see how we go. So we need some video editing software. You can use anything you like. I'm using Premiere Pro. So here we are in Premiere Pro. Now in the bottom left hand window there, I'm going to click import and I'm going to open the colored images folder. Select the first image, select image sequence and open. That brings the whole sequence into Premiere Pro, and what I can do now is drag it over onto this timeline, and it has actually stitched all those images together. So all we need now is a soundtrack. So I'm now going to import the original clip, which is this one, and that goes up in this left hand window at the top, because once it's up there you can actually, you see this sign here, that is the what, that is the soundtrack on this clip. So we can drag that soundtrack underneath this clip, which is our new clip, and that will now make it perfect, hopefully. Right, we're going to render it, export it as a video, and then we'll see what it comes out like, I think. So we go File, Export, Media. I normally select 1080p on here, but you can select any quality setting that you want, really. And then export, and it won't take too long. 1 minute 40 seconds this one is going to take, and then we'll come back and we'll have a look at the finished video clip. So I've got the finished video clip on my desktop now. Let's take a look, see how it came out, shall
we? He's also the Eastern Seaboard Head of Operations for Thrush.
Can we take him?
Not yet, unfortunately. However, we intercepted his last communication from Thrush and decoded it to read, when the Premier of Western Rutumba visits our plant, we must assassinate.
That's all?
At that point, the message was garbled and lost. Now, the Premier of this newly independent nation is visiting Washington, D.C. right now. You, Mr. Solo, must go there immediately and prevent the assassination of this man. Channel D will brief you.
Well, there you go. That didn't come out too bad at all. So I hope that's given other people the idea to try one for themselves. Well, thanks very much for watching my video. I hope it's helped a lot of people out and given them some inspiration to try some colorizing for themselves. Have a nice day, and please like and subscribe.